Welcome back to Mystic Voyager. Hope you are doing great. And you might be wondering what I'm doing with all these traditional clothes, jewelry, big jhumkas and all. Well, the month of August is very special to me and I've never really opened up about this to most people. And today I thought probably I'll do on that. So this YouTube video is not a travel vlog, it's something from my heart. So we'll all be having different occasions and big events in our life. When I think about such events, of course the last one, my wedding, was the huge step I've ever taken in my life. But before my wedding, if someone asks me which is your best moment, well, I tell it's my Bharatanatyam Arangetram. It happened 12 years before, in 2009. On 10th of August. So when the August vibes hit in, I always remember the extra strenuous practices and the extra efforts that all of us took to make the event a big success. Anyways, so today's vlog and the upcoming vlogs, maybe two or three depending on the content, will be on my Bharatanatyam Arangetram. Okay, so I'm not prepared for this, but I make sure I give in all of my emotions and all of what I feel in this video. To begin, actually, Arangetram is a very familiar word with most of us, right? Either you would have attended or you would have performed. And Arangetram literally means to get onto the stage for the first time and to display everything at your maximum potential in front of the audience. So you might be wondering, okay, so before that, if we dance, what is that? Well, see, we might be performing maybe one or two or three dances, but Arangetram goes on for hours, probably 4 hours or even more than that. And dancing for 4 hours is definitely a huge thing, at least to me. You need great stamina, you need the willpower, and you need passion for that. So, during my Arangetram, I used to wonder what is so special about this, and only when I got onto that particular stage, I've been on different stages, but only when I got onto that particular stage, it hit me. Okay, this is something massive. The word Arangetram can be split into two parts. It's Arangu and Etram. Arangu in Tamil or Arangu in Malayalam, which means stage, and Etram means to get onto in Tamil. So basically, the first time you're getting onto the stage to show every possible thing on that particular art, every possible thing that you have learned, that you have absorbed, that you want to show the audience, it happens during Arangetram. There is something called Chalanga Poojai before Arangetram. Usually people do that, but it's not compulsory. Chalanga Poojai is considered to be the first time when you wear the Chalanga, which means the gungru around your head. My Arangetram, like I said, it took place on 10th of August 2009. And I did it with few of my classmates who studied with me back then. Arangetram usually comes for dance and music, that's what I've heard. If you're a painter, if you want to show your exhibits, you put up an exhibition, right? So that is the first time you're showing your whole potential to a set of audience. Well, that is also an Arangetram, but literally we don't call that word. But it's all the same and it applies to every single field. So I learned this art form for almost 15 to 16 years and I've been under the guidance of 2 to 3 gurus, but the maximum time I spent with my guru, Shri Sudish. So Sudish sir has always been close to my heart when it comes to dance, and he has taught us the maximum that any guru can teach. And he was always linked to our school. So whenever there was any school programs or anything of that sort, it was him who's choreographing. And after that we'd go for dance class and it's him there as well. So it's basically Sudhir sir everywhere. So he's an exceptional torchbearer of the Kalakshetra form of dance. And he's been teaching for so many years. Before that, I had been under Karwar and sir also. But maximum time it was under Sudhir sir. He was amazing at it. So I still remember my dance class days, my practices, and you know, when I get time, I flip into the images, through the videos, and I remember, you know, at times we feel lazy to go to dance classes and all, and that's when sir will call up and be like, Pandu, where are you? So I'm at home, I have this homework, that homework, he's like, first you have to come and dance. So next class, I should be there, that's all, there's no this or that. He was really a great teacher that anyone could get, and actually he persuaded me to continue, but in time, after my 10th standard, they were boards, and after that college was pretty far, and I could not pursue it. At times I play the music and I dance for it. Probably I don't have the same stamina and all, but the love is still there. I learned Bharatanatyam, and this Arangetram, under different gurus, it is different way. So some gurus, they teach for 2 years, 3 years, and then they want their disciples to perform the Arangetram. Some gurus take even 20 years, 22 years, and finally they ask them to do their Arangetram. So mine happened probably after 13 to 14 years. Why some people prefer this 2 to 3 years is some just want to learn the art form and probably migrate to different other art forms. So like when you learn Bharatanatyam, it's easier to do Kathak is pretty easier, and even Kuchipudi is very easier. Kuchipudi and Bharatanatyam, usually some people say like when you're learning Bharatanatyam, it's easier to do Kuchipudi. And Mohiniyattam, yes, few people learn, but Mohiniyattam is more of a feminine form. So it's like a sway, and Bharatanatyam has more of stiff moments, so stiff and strong moments. So when you are learning Mohiniyattam first and then you come for Bharatanatyam, probably the moments might not be as strong because you already learned the sway way, so might not do justice. That's what I feel, but there are exceptional cases who do better. But when it's Kuchipudi, I don't think you have. It's more of leg work. So, yes, it's a small piece of advice. If you are aspiring to become a dancer, and if you have that passion in you, and if you feel this is the right time, you go for it. Almost 12 years for me to do this video, and I wanted this Arangetram video to be on YouTube because it's very close to my heart. Like I said, I want it to be there on the internet. I want people to see it because as of now only my family people have seen it, or maybe probably some of my friends. So now, you know, extended people can watch this, so that's why I'm uploading this video. I'll be uploading probably 2 or 3 videos, depending on the content, I'll let you guys know. And every single time I'm uploading a video, maybe a short story or something which I've been through, I'll share with you guys. So we were also blessed to perform in front of our chief guest. The first chief guest for the event was Professor Janardhanan sir. He's the trauma principal of Kalakshetra Foundation. The next chief guest was the director of Tapasya Kala Sampradaya, Srimati Indu Jayanti Varma. If you are aspiring to become a classical dancer, or if you want your kids to join, yes, it's the best time. You know, there are lots of options right now, and there are online classes also, and hopefully, you know, once all this corona gets settled, you can send your kids, you can go by yourself to such classes. So I hope you all like my video, and I hope you all like this series as well, because this is like part 1, part 2 and part 3. Please do support my channel. Please do like, share and subscribe. So let's move on to the video. Be
Mm-hmm.